Па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па-па Legend и Figure Чернов. Your favorite RPG asshole, right? And the best, and the worst, I suppose. Guy who just tried to talk English, but he anyway do this, right? Today, I want to talk to you about best, objectively best CRPG of all times, right? It's Baldur's Gate 2. Why is the best? I don't know. Happens. Well, to be perfectly honest, this is the golden era of BioWare, obviously, right? It's Baldur's Gate, Knights of the Old Republic, Neverwinter Nights, right? But it's all start with Baldur's Gate. A lot of people compare Baldur's Gate 2 to Dragon Age 1 for some reason, but it's obviously just, it's stupid, right? Never, ever, Dragon Age will be compared to Baldur's Gate, because Baldur's Gate is the best, you know, just objectively, without anime style, because if we... Tales of Phantasia is supposed to be anime-styled, the successor of Lord of the Rings, right? In the JRPG gaming section, right? Because it's objectively an epic adventure with multiple extraordinary hard dungeons to beat, right? Extraordinary hard, spells to get. You got, game like Baldur's Gate, right? Which is objectively supposed to be this classy JRPG, right? On the brink of being a fantasy and dark fantasy both, right? Because you got a lot of really dark shit what happening in this game, right? You can take an example on this typical quest from Baldur's Gate 1 when Edwin tried to just find and sell a maestress, right? What Minsk actually want to protect. Right? And it's all been combined in this Forgotten Realms universe when you got like the Red Wizards of Tay, right? Rashomon region, right? And Minsk is not supposed to be a ranger, he's supposed to be this guy called Berserker, right? Who's supposed to just protect the witch, or witches actually, from this region. What's supposed to be a ruler? What's supposed to be some sort of circle of people who rule actually this region, right? Which is Rashomon actually, right? So it's like the origin. Why it's like people continue to ask why you got like this somewhat unique magic about Baldur's Gate, right? With unique chemistry, again, talking about chemistry, right? And atmosphere and aesthetics, right? It's all about Forgotten Realms. People continue to ask, why Neverwinter Nights happened to be this legendary RPG? Why Baldur's Gate this legendary RPG? Why Icewind Dale is supposed to be this legendary RPG? It's all because Forgotten Realms. How will Forgotten Realms work and how it's been written? Forgotten Realms is the best fantasy universe, objectively. Much better than anything that you just ever see or read in your life. When you start to understand, you got these popular MMORPGs, like, World of Warcraft, and they think they got good and well-written universe, right? These people who play MMORPG like World of Warcraft, right? Or Elder Scrolls MMO, or even a single player Elder Scrolls games. They think what their universe is supposed to be well-written, but they have no idea how small their universes are supposed to be compared to Forgotten Realms. Forgotten Realms is just Alpha and Omega, it's beginning and the end. It's the best, objectively best fantasy universe in a nutshell, right? And that's why Baldur's Gate continue to be the best RPG of all time, because it's just basically create a concept, right? And I'm not talking only about Baldur's Gate 2, I talk about the Baldur's Gate trilogy, obviously, right? We're not supposed to compare 1 to 2, to 2, or to Throne of Baal. We just obviously understand what it's the part of the trilogy. Even the Dragonspear DLC from BeamDog are, well, kinda supposed to be also well written, actually, to be perfectly honest, and supposed to be part of the universe. Yeah, a lot of people just being extremely skeptical, right, about the enhanced edition of the game, but I think the BeamDog do best possible, actually, on just option for us to buy this game in modern times, actually, right? Because it's upscaled, right? It just plays well. They still continue to update, and Neverwinter Nights 1 and Baldur's Gate 2. Yeah, it's just for some people they will say it's a money grab, but I mean, I just shut up and take my money, okay, right? I'm not feeling myself deceived to something like that, right? I buy Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition, right? 1 and 2, I'll just when they first released an enhanced edition of the first game, right? Like the Baldur's Gate 1 Enhanced Edition, actually, with the blue interface, right? At that time I already bought it, actually, right? Because it was the best possible I'll just deal for you to just have a modern copy of a Baldur's Gate, right? Well, digital copy, obviously, right? There's supposed to be a lot of people who just care about just physical copies, but I, to be perfectly honest, don't give a damn, actually, about physical copies. I only prefer myself just buying a digital copy, right? Because I just don't want to have my room being I don't want to be surrounded by by a bunch of games and boxes, you know? But anyway, like Baldur's Gate, in a nutshell, is epic, classic fantasy adventure, right? It's kind of obvious what it's like. A lot of people already said shut out actually about Baldur's Gate. But I mean, what make Baldur's Gate actually so special, right? I already explained, right? It's the universe, it's Forgotten Realms, right? Why is just I have no idea why BioWare actually take Forgotten Realms as a core universe and or as an anchor, right? Because you got like universes like Ravenloft, right? Or Dark Sun, for example, right? And you got like this Forgotten Realms, right? Universe with all this mythology and twists, right? Like, but I mean, the way how huge Forgotten Realms are just supposed to be, right? It's just enormous to just even just talk about it, actually, to be perfectly honest, right? Because, I mean, for example, in Baldur's Gate 3, we got this typical rivalship between the, this fight, right, between the two races, Illithids and Githyanki, right? And there's not a lot of people who just know what they're supposed to be two parts of these people, which is Gith people, and previously they need to be human beings, right? But it's like since the time I'm not supposed to be where it's not supposed to be like what's happening right now, right? Time is supposed to be the time supposed to have a past, future, and now times, right? Well, obviously it's the metaphysics, all of this bullshit, right? Because I don't believe in time traveling, to be perfectly honest, right? Because it's not even supposed to be a part of real physics. But we're not talking about real life anyway, right? We talk about the world, right? Only the world of the imagination, right? Or just, fictionary, right? So we're supposed to be, it's like, people who previously been people, but throughout the, being slaves to the Illithids, right? And they been actually conquered by Illithids, right? All human beings, actually, in the universe, right? As far as I remember the Forgotten Realms lore, you're supposed to just, this Gith people он же Unreal People before, they evolve actually to become GIF, right, and become more protective against the elites, and they got this new looks actually of the GIF Yankee and Gizerai, right, but it's basically the part of the same folk actually, right, but they being divided, like, Gizerai is supposed to be like this, I don't know, just Japan warriors, I don't know, just like Ronins or something like that, right, they need to be calm and they live in this very strange world called Limp, right? Where your imagination can basically build a castle and create a monster. So you, basically, if you will see what a nightmare, right? At night time, this nightmare can just can materialize, right? And kill you, basically, right? So you need to control your emotions every time, right? And that's why Gizerai. Just priestess are supposed to be so calm, actually, right? And so wise, right? In Neverwinter Nights 2, which is also supposed to be a part of the RPG Legend, Legends series of videos, right? And you see, it's like, that's what make Forgotten Realms Forgotten Realms. It's well written, right? Above that, It's like in this game you just it's called Baldur's Gate, but you basically just play in the you found yourself in the middle of Atkatla, right? The city in Amn, right? It's different region. It's not even Baldur's Gate, right? And that's why it's called Shadows of Amn, right? And I'm moment convinced actually when they just come just take the Baldur's Gate 3 name, we obviously care about the brand, right? But why you need a brand when you can create something new, right? So, we already got the Baldur's Gate, right? We already got Neverwinter Nights. Why not, I don't know, just make something like Waterdeep, right? Because for any Forgotten Realms fan, they totally will have a goosebumps when I just mention this name of the city, right? Because it's basically been the capital of capitals, right? In the Forgotten Realms universe, right? Waterdeep is extremely big city, actually, right? Much bigger, if I'm not mistaken, when I'll just compare to Baldur's Gate and Neverwinter Nights, both, actually, right? And all these provinces, like Cormyr, right? These cities like Laskan, right, and all of this become this, why Forgotten Realms again is the best fantasy universe, right? Because it's just make you in harmony. Any people, any sort of people make it through and feel the harmony of this universe, right? It's basically It's better to just describe this universe with one word. It's harmony, right? It's harmonized with you, actually, right? Yeah, you got, like, Elder Scrolls universe, right? You got World of Warcraft universe and ours, I suppose, right? But this one is much better, actually, right? And when you understand the difference, right? When you play all these games like Icewind Dale and Baldur's Gate, you totally understand, it's like, why it's so different, right? And I can compare Forgotten Realms only to just something like Shin Megami Tensei universe, for some reason, because it's also well written and just go through some games like, not even supposed to be some sort of spin-offs, right? Like Devil Summoner or Persona games, right? It's not supposed to be even a part of the universe, actually, part of the same universe, actually, right? Because in Shin Megami Tensei, you basically summon a demon and just summon demons, right? Right, was supposed to just be companions of yours, right? And it's like, I don't know, just for some reason, the only series of games what I can compare to Forgotten Realms universe, right, is just Shin Megami Tensei. For some reason, I don't know. And Baldur's Gate, it's like, objectively, right, is the just best RPG, game of all times, I already make a take, actually, I just make an example, right? Planescape Torment, objectively, is the best RPG, right? But it's the best RPG. Right, and you, yeah, you still call it, you can call it it's RPG, right? But I mean, it's like the way how the Baldur's Gate works in every way, in the way of gameplay, characters, music, and everything, and it's not supposed to have any, I'll just, things in style what you don't like. So, for example, why people don't play JRPGs? Because they don't like anime-styled games, right? They never will play Dragon Quest because it's anime-style game, right? They need this, you know, just Western, typical, dark fantasy, brown, gray shit, right? It's like, without this, dubstep elements, right? Because a lot of people will just continue to just compare anime to dubstep, right? And be like, well, this is like dubstep, right? It's not like this. It's like people just don't want to open their mind for something new, right? They just continue to sit in their own box, right? Of their own mind and just don't even try to crush it, actually, right? For some reason. But yeah, Baldur's Gate not supposed to just annoy you at all, right? Even if you're supposed to be a modern player, right? It's like, this game, even if you just choose the highest difficulty at the beginning, right? You will struggle, but you will understand what this game is actually for everyone, right? And it's kind of funny, the BioWare totally understand it, right? BioWare, you know, the game design of the BioWare is always just about, like, helping the player, right? You got a lot of scrolls, a lot of magic, a lot of, I don't know, just different stuff, like unique weapons, right, and armor. For everyone, actually, right? You can play a bard and you not feel yourself like and play like an idiot, right? And feel yourself like an idiot both, right? Like in Pathfinder Kingmaker, for example, right? Because compare this to a lot of people compare Kingmaker to Baldur's Gate, right? And compare Kingmaker to Baldur's Gate, it's like, compare a lion to mouse, right? To make it simple. Because how bugged Pathfinder Kingmaker still are, actually, right? It's like when you see your Steam activity section, right? You always just see the Pathfinder Wrath of Rage game, right? In it, right? And you all the time see how people whining again and again about bugs in this game, right? Because it's unplayable, to be perfectly honest, right? I try to play Wrath of Rage, it's fucking unplayable. I have no idea how you play play all cat games, people. I mean, it's beyond me, to be perfectly honest. And that's why, people just continue to ask me, actually, why you just spent like 300 hours in Kingmaker? Because I just try to have fun with this game again and again, but I just can't, because I again and again found some stupid shit bug, or just some image of a debuff not supposed to show. Or you don't have a bug description, right? Or just debuff description, right? And you sitting and be like, what this shit actually do, right? Even the early versions of Baldur's Gate, I still remember this shit, actually, right? When you just, weapon is supposed to disappear, right? From the box, right? Or from the chest, actually, right? In Baldur's Gate. And you need to just, install the patch and this patch actually supposed to broke something new, right? But even this not supposed to, you're not even supposed to compare the most shitty Obsidian games to the Pathfinder Kingmaker or Wrath of Rages. It's just pure bullshit, right? We just need to hire really good people, actually, who supposed to get their shit together, actually, right? And it's like, I totally like, a lot of people actually whine about BeamDog, how BeamDog broke this game, right? But compared to Kingmaker, right? It's the most optimized PC game ever made, actually, right? Even on consoles, right? Because we actually ported on console, right? After, 20 years, I suppose, right? Or less than 20. Well, it doesn't matter, actually, to be perfectly honest, right? Best possible experience for you to play is Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition, obviously, right? any just part of the story, right? Like, oh, but yeah, obviously you need to play from start to finish to understand the story because they are connected, right? Well, Baldur's Gate 1, it's the same character. You will be playing the same character, you know, just in Baldur's Gate 2 and it's supposed to be the real Baldur's Gate 3 with this, but it's called Anadan, right? Throne of Baal, but it's basically Baldur's Gate 3 actually, right? And it's kind of short one, but not that short, right? And you objectively can call this Baldur's Gate 3, right? You got like 1, 2, and 3, which is Throne of Baal actually, right? And it's the part of the same story. Extremely epic. This story is kind of bold, to be perfectly honest. A lot of people, again, continue to just compare Baldur's Gate 2 to Neverwinter Nights 2 and say the Neverwinter Nights 2 is supposed to have a more mediocre story, actually, compared to Baldur's Gate, but it's a pure bullshit. Neverwinter Nights 2 with Mask of Betrayer kick this game arse, actually, to be perfectly honest, right? It's like, I don't know, just, it's like, it's like you compare World of Warcraft Vanilla, right? To the Burning Crusade add-on, right? All this cosmic, I don't know, just new world, actually, right? Of Draenor, right? And you got, like, the vanilla world of Warcraft, right? And this is the Baldur's Gate 2, being compared to the Neverwinter Nights 2, actually, right? With Mask of Betrayer. Because it's also supposed to be an epic story with an add-on, right? But it's much more bigger, actually. And to be perfectly honest, Neverwinter Nights 2 with Mask of Betrayer is basically a standalone game, right? It's just not even supposed to be an add-on. How Obsidian, it's like, how much effort Obsidian put in this add-ons, actually, of Neverwinter Nights 2, nobody knows. But they do much better job, actually, compared to Owlcat, for example, right? And people still just say, and just shit about, like, say shit about the Obsidian, how buggy they was back in the days, right? But compared to Owlcat, they just do the best and perfect optimized games ever made, actually, on PC, to be perfectly honest, right? But BioWare, I don't know, just very strange combination, what is just bunch of geeks, actually, playing Dungeons and Dragons and love all these worlds of Forgotten Realms and totally feel this, have this feeling what Forgotten Realms is gonna be big, actually, right, in the future, and we actually done that, right? And this game is Baldur's Gate 2, basically, right? Oh, no, it's like Baldur's Gate Trilogy, right? Again, it's not about only Baldur's Gate, like, Baldur's Gate 2, 1, right? It's just, it's need to be trilogy, right? Because it is trilogy. It's Baldur's Gate 1, you got the small add-on over Baldur's Gate 1, sword cost something, if I'm not mistaken, right? Oh, Dulrak Tower, if I'm not mistaken, right? It's basically some sort of a dungeon crawler, actually, right? At some point, right? In this game. And yeah, story is kind of dark. It's kind of the part of the universe, right? It's not supposed to be the side of a spin-off or something like that, right? But when you realize how this difference between Baldur's Gate 1 and 2, right? So it's biggest cliffhanger ever, actually, when you just wake up in Baldur's Gate 2 and understand how fucked up your just situation is supposed to be compared to the first game, right? Because you in the first game you will be at some point you will think what everything is just so bad, right? But when you start Baldur's Gate 2, you'll be like, okay, that was walk in the park, actually, right? The real trouble starts now, actually, right? And how these characters are evolved, right? From the first game to the second game, like Imaen, right? Or just Vyconia, right? When you just see Vyconia in Baldur's Gate 2, you be like, what happening, actually, right? So it's like how the characters are evolving, actually, right? And it's pure BioWare, right? It's like you can talk to a character like it's human being. It's actually a human being. Yeah, Baldur's Gate 1 is not supposed to have a lot of dialogues actually between your characters, right? But in Baldur's Gate 2, this evolution of just dialogue system, right? It's something new actually, right? It's continued to be the golden standard of in RPGs, right? How a BioWare create all this, I don't know, just aesthetic madness, right? When you first time talk to, I don't know, just characters in Knights of Old Republic, like Cartanasi, for example, right? It's just created its own chemistry, and you totally understand what this guy is your true friend, actually, right? Beyond the mirror, right? Of your monitor, right? Oh, beyond the mirror. Oh, beyond your, I don't know, just, it's like you having a friend from another world, you know? It totally feels like it, actually, right? I'm not talking about the continuation of the story in Knights of Old Republic, and characters like Kreia, actually, right? And how, dark it's become in, Star Wars universe, like, how dark it's become in second game, right? Which is Knights of Old Republic, Sith Lords, right? And this game, and it's kind of funny what everything is is messed up, Blizzard Obsidian. I continue to mess up with the company's names, right? I mean, it's kind of funny how Obsidian and BioWare try hard to have this some sort of a weird rivalship, but it's not supposed to be even a rivalship, right? It's like they just try to quoting themselves actually, right? In different games. So, for example, Planescape Torment is more dark and mature story than Baldur's Gate 1, for example, right? But Baldur's Gate 2 is much more mature, actually, and dark compared to Baldur's Gate 1, right? Same goes with Neverwinter Nights 2, for example, right? Neverwinter Nights 2 are supposed to be kind of like this typical, I don't know, just classic fantasy, but it's become more dark, actually, right? In Mask of Betrayer, right? And it's continue to be classic fantasy in Storm of Zihir, actually, right? And if you can describe, it's like Baldur's Gate 1 are supposed to be classic fantasy, right? Baldur's Gate 2 is kind of like semi-dark classic fantasy, right? And Baldur's Gate, Throne of Baal is supposed to be like semi-dark classic epic fantasy, right? At some point, because you... Well, basically become a god, right? In the end. But you are in any actually JRPG and RPG, and it's not supposed to be a huge spoiler, because how a character grows actually, right? He always just try to just from a simple human being, he just can to challenge the god in the end, right? It's kind of funny what this scenario work both and in JRPGs, right? And in classic RPGs, and in Western RPGs, and any RPGs, right? You always start to be a human being, right? And end up to being a god, right? And it's like one of the few RPGs where you actually, even if you are supposed to be some sort of warlord, right? You're anyway supposed to be simple human being, right? Like, like in Mountain Blade, for example, right? You're just basically being a simple unit, right? And that's what. But above that, it's like that's the classic BioWare actually, in a nutshell, right? If you ever try to play it, right, it's totally not supposed to be just waste of your time, right? If you ever have a thought why people like games, you can play Baldur's Gate, and after some point something eventually, right? If you will have this inner feeling that something about this game is really attractive to me, right? It will switch eventually, actually, in your brain, and you understand what it's like. This game is epic. How to describe it with one word? This game is epic, right? Sick. It's like, you're not supposed to struggle, right? Even if you choose the hardest difficulty, BioWare think about you every time, right? It will give you much more experience compared to the normal difficulty, for example, right? You will struggle, but you understand what you will learn game mechanics more well with the hardest difficulties, right? You will challenge a dragon, a beholder, any type of these enemies, like elites, right, in this game, actually, right? The hardest enemies of this game, right? You will totally understand what it was worth it, actually, right? That's, you know, just what you can call a struggling difficulty, struggling hardcore, right? When you can overcome it, not like in Chitty, Pathfinder, Kingmaker, you just need to go solo and people just crit you with 60 or 70 damage, right? And you got like hit dice like 12, right? If you choose Barbarian, for example, right? And you'd be like, this game is just shitting with me, right? This game will not shit with you, right? This game will not deceive you, right? Yeah, you will just have just tough times with some bosses, with some enemies, with the traps, with all of this just typical stuff of being CRPG, right? But it's worth it, right? That's the golden standard and the game design of BioWare, right? Like, what everything is perfect in this game. Like in some, I don't know, just like, it's like, I don't just, first iPhone, I don't know, just you just understand what people just the simple people who straightly do the right and good thing, actually, right? That's BioWare for you. That's Ray Muzika, Greg Zeschuk for you, right? All these people who've been responsible for Baldur's Gate. It's just the bunch of people who just make a good game, right? It's like without weird shit, right? That's what it's like on one hand, it's simple, right? On our hand, it's kind of funny what people can't even copy-paste it, right? Just take example Pathfinder Kingmaker, right? The game kinda look not so, it's not supposed to be game like Pathfinder Kingmaker, right? It's have a good graphics, but it's anyway supposed to be old. Old isometric RPG, right? Only thing you need to do is just fix the bugs. But we can't even do this, actually. Right. And in Baldur's Gate, you're not supposed to find any bugs, actually, to be perfectly honest, as far as I understand, right? With Enhanced Edition, there's supposed to be some bugs still, right? But they're supposed to be like, we're not supposed to break your game or just make you suffer, right? Like in Pathfinder Kingmaker, right? You see, it's like, overall, if you just... it's not supposed to be a waste of your time. When you just at some point really compared to the Kingmaker, right? You just have this strange feeling that this game is actually bullshitting you, right? It's just deceiving you. Like, I just fight with enemies here and be one-shotted where, right? And you'd be like, how is this possible, right? And in Baldur's Gate, you will never have this feeling, actually, right? Yeah, you will just will be fucked up by a leech, for example, right? Who cast stop time, right? And just the screen turns gray and he just cast some multiple spells on you, right? And be like, okay. Right, but when you realize what you need to, for example, dispel him, he's supposed to be a mage of some sort, right? And you easily can just go toward him, right, and just basically kill him, right, in no time, right? If you use a dispel, right, or strong dispel on him, right, and it turns out to what almost all encounters are you can handle, right, in Baldur's Gate, and this game. You totally understand what, yeah, it's hard, but I can handle. And that's by our game design, right? And I don't just, it's like, One of the best romances in gaming industry. It's like, if you ever play some, I don't know, just hentai novella or any novella, even like, I don't know, just Fate Stay Night, this is nothing compared to the three romances of this game, which is in Baldur's Gate 2, actually, right? Because when you start to talk with Jaheira or Vyconia or Airi in this game, and yeah, it kind of sucks to just play this game as a female, right? No sexism, I suppose, right? But that's just how it is, right? As far as I understand, in their mind, they be like, okay, most of the people actually are supposed to be. Most of the guys are supposed to be. Most of the people who play the game are supposed to be guys, right? And not girls, actually, right? Because girls don't play games. It's a cliche, but that's how it is, right? And the only just female option in this game, I'll just. Character to have a romance with. To female character, right, it's Anomen, right, this character, right, in this game is the most asshole, stupid shit, cunt character of all Baldur's Gate, right, even in their internet, we're supposed to be one asshole called Bishop, actually, right, and he was much worse than Anomen, actually, right? But Anomen, I don't know, I just play like, couple of times with female character. I never romance Anomen, to be perfectly honest, in Baldur's Gate, because the guy, I want to punch him. If I was a girl, I never have a relationship with this guy, actually, right? Punch him, yes. Have a relationship with him, fuck no. Right? And same goes with... talking about the romances, right, Vyconia, objectively, for me, it's the best romance in this game, right, the more tragic one, actually, to be perfectly honest, right, the most classic one is just Jaheira romance, right, and the, I don't know, Loli romance, right, it's Airi, right, if you've been in, I don't know, just some sort of anime fan, and you, if you have a loli romance in this game, you can choose Airi, because she supposed to be the most youngest girl in this game, actually, right? As far as I remember, right? Well, and to be perfectly honest, I'll just fair set, what it's like, all the characters are, I don't know, just transform from the Baldur's Gate 1, and how they just transform in, it's like, in different way is really just... surprise you, right, in the end, because it's like where you got like a certain mage character, a female mage character, right, magistress in this game, what supposed to be kind of like do-gooder, I don't know, just typical do-gooder character at the beginning, right, but she becomes so much more, I don't know, just dark in the Throne of Baal, right? Which is Nalia, for example. It's like, you see, a lot of people actually, when we play Mass Effect, asking all these questions, like, why this character, from the first game, like, Mass Effect, like, Ashley, if I'm not mistaken, become this cynical in the third game, but, I mean, take example, like, character like Nalia, right? She also become so much cynical, to be perfectly honest. She was a so naive magistress at the beginning of the story and become so cynical in the end. And that's the Baldur's Gate in a nutshell, right? The characters are evolved like a real human being, right? They been through tough times and it's not supposed to just do... not supposed to affect you well in the end, right? And you can... continue to talk about Baldur's Gate 2, right? You can make a lot of examples, how the gameplay of this game is perfect, right? Magic system, right? You got all these different kids class, right? What else is supposed to be extremely important to choose, right? My favorite, well, just class in this game is the Paladin Inquisitor, right? Because you basically can dispel every fucking dragon, every fucking lich in this game and just annihilate them. They melting, right? Under the just, just heal of the Holy Avenger Sword, right? Because if you ever, when you got this sword in your hands, right, in this game, you totally feel yourself, yourself like a fucking Jedi, you know, just, you got a lightsaber in your hands, and all these, fantasy characters will be destroyed, right, by you. That's why my favorite class in Baldur's Gate, in any RPG or JRPG, right? It's Paladin. I don't know. It's like in World of Warcraft, my favorite character is a Paladin, right? And just to play because I just like to be Paladin, right? Or Death Knight, I suppose, right? It's like not just a warrior, but this special warrior with the twist, right? Like with Paladin magic, or they actually add option to be a dark Paladin in this game, right? In Baldur's Gate 2, actually, right? Enhanced edition, right? And you see, it's like you can continuously actually talk about Baldur's Gate, right? But it will be, I already just talked like for 40 minutes. I'm not supposed to say anything new, to be perfectly honest, about Baldur's Gate, right? But objectively, it's just best CRPG of all time, right? Without shit. If for me Planescape Torment is supposed to be the best RPG, this is the best CRPG objectively, right? Baldur's Gate trilogy is the proof what gaming and games itself have a huge amount of effort and a huge amount of art, right? It's my heart bleeds actually when I see what people like Ray Muzyka or Greg Zeschuk actually quitting this industry, right? And left BioWare. But what you gonna do, right? Since they sell their assets actually to Electronic Arts, and Electronic Arts, it's like Hand of Maidens. The hand of Midas, but otherwise, right? All they touch turn out to be shit, to be very honest. For what reason, I have no idea, but that's how it is, right? Sadly, they sell their company, and there is no BioWare today. They still have a label, which is BioWare, right? It's like Microsoft still have a label, which is Obsidian, right? But without Chris Avellone, Obsidian is not Obsidian. It's just constant truth, right? And it's kind of funny what all these RPGs, what Chris Avellone touch actually, right? I become pure legend, right? Like, again, Pathfinder, Divinity, right? But when the people compare Baldur's Gate 2 to the Pathfinder, they totally wrong, right? Because this game just not Baldur's Gate, right? And the true successor is just Divinity Original Sin. It's kind of unpopular opinion, but that's why we just give rights for Baldur's Gate 3 to Larian. Because Larian will make game for everyone, right? You will, again, it's the same game design, right? It's just the bunch of good people with straight brain, I suppose, right? What you need to make a cool RPG. Not this piece of shit Kingmaker or Wrath of Rages where you're supposed to struggle and through difficulty, and through how the dice work in this game, right? What you're constantly missing and your enemy constantly hit you, right? It look like it's bullshit. In Baldur's Gate, you will never have it, right? And in just Divinity Original Sin, you will never have it. Yeah, you still got like this chance like to just miss a hit with 20 or 10%. And when you miss, you be like, fuck. But you continue to hit, right? Because you totally understand what it was a fluke. It's just a fluke, right? But in Kingmaker, you're constantly missing, right? Like, and you feel yourself like you're being an idiot, right? You just can't stand it. And that's why I like and love Baldur's Gate 2, actually, right? Or just all trilogy, I suppose, right? Because this RPG is cool. That's how you just make an RPG, right? That's how, if I was a game designer, I want to just make games like this, actually, right? And I totally know how to do this, right? You need to play it your own, right? You need to play with your own hands, actually, right? You need to test it every day, right? Every build, right? And just talk to people, right? Like, you need to change this thing, I don't know, just you need to change this, that, and just, you need to make an example, right? How to change this and that, actually, right? And way of balance, when it's like this location, just have too many enemies, right? You need to just, decrease them, right? You need to just put this, archer, just this way, right? And yeah, it sound kind of stupid, but I mean, when you just actually start to work with anything, right? I totally understand what we are supposed to be a people actually know how to build stuff actually, right? And we are supposed to be some specific people who just put something specific in their own games actually, right? Some strange game design. And that's why I'm just never will compare just Baldur's Gate and just Kingmaker, right? And never put something like Pathfinder into the RPG Legends, right? It will never be like Neverwinter Nights or Baldur's Gate or Icewind Dale, right? It's a good try, but it's not enough. In a way of balance, the game is total bullshit, to be perfectly honest. And Baldur's Gate, right? If you choose the hardest difficulty, right? No, you're not supposed to just struggle because it's well balanced hardcore RPG, right? Same goes with Icewind Dale. If you want to go just through, you can just play Heart of Fury in Icewind Dale, right? Or Legacy of Baal in this game, right? There's supposed to be a lot of munchkins who's supposed to just basically annihilate any difficulty in any game, obviously, right? Or speedrunners, I suppose, right? But I mean, I'm talking about the first experience, right? For most of the people, it will be first experience, and you're not supposed to struggle, right? Because you're not a speedrunner, right? It's kind of obvious. But I mean, Baldur's Gate basically make of you a hardcore player, right? You will start to just make mistakes, but this game not supposed to just throw you on spikes, I don't know, right? It's supposed to just actually help you, right? It's like a good teacher actually who hit you, right? And be like, you feel the pain, you will be like, yes, when now you're learning actually, right? But next punch will be not that heavy, right? You almost not feel it, right? And your first time face a dragon in Baldur's Gate, you'd be like, okay, it's a gigantic fucking beast, how am I supposed to beat it? But when you realize that, oh yeah, obviously he breathes fire or acid, right? I just need protection from fire, right? I just need to cast protection from fire, right? So you'll be annihilated at the first, but when you start to just think, right, about how you're supposed to just beat encounter, right? It's not about like, it will not about it's not about throwing a dice, right? It was all about strategy and planning, actually, right? How you shuffle your party, how you what class do you choose, right? What artifacts do you use? What weapons do you use? Potions and everything, right? You totally feel yourself in charge, actually, right? And that's why Baldur's Gate continue to be a golden standard of CRPGs, and it's was and will be the best CRPG, right? And the best game design, game design game in CRPG section possible, actually, right? If you ever want to just try, right, to make an RPG, just play Baldur's Gate and try to do the same, right? Throughout all these times, I don't know, let's just try to do something, and only Obsidian actually No, I'll just do a true successor of Baldur's Gate, which is Pillars of Eternity, right? Even if you choose Path of Adam in Pillars of Eternity, you will feel yourself like, yeah, I'm struggling, but I still handle it, right? And it's not about, like, when it's not this bullshit gameplay from Pathfinder and Kingmaker when you're constantly missing. And you feel yourself like an idiot, right? So, Baldur's Gate 2, the golden standard of the RPGs, well-earned spot in my own top of tops of all RPGs, right? Just all best RPGs in history, which is RPG Legends, right? Baldur's Gate, BioWare, it was my childhood, right? It's the true meaning of this game is the true meaning and avatar of what RPGs are supposed to be.